everyone. In the previous lecture, we have learned about forward differences and backward differences. Now today we look into the new concept, that is interpolation. That is, if y0, y1, y2, so on up to yn be the set of values corresponding to the values of x, that is x0, x1, so on up to xn, then the process of finding the value of y for any given value of x between x0 and xn is called as interpolation. It means that finding the value of y for a given x between the initial value and the last value, that is x0 and xn, which will be called as interpolation. Here also we have two methods, that is Newton's forward interpolation formula and Newton's backward interpolation formula. Please remember, in the forward interpolation formula we are using the y0 terms, and in the backward differences we are using the yn, I mean the last term. Okay, now please note here, the process of estimating the value of y for some value of x outside the interval, that is x0, xn, then it is called as extrapolation. If they told you to calculate the value of y for some value of x, if it is not lying between x0 and xn, it is lying outside the xn means, then we are saying it as extrapolation. For example, they tell you to calculate the value of 100, that x will be equal to 100, but they will be given x0 will be given 10 and xn will be your 90. Then 100 is crossing 90, therefore that 100, that x, is called as an extrapolation value. Now we look into the two methods. First we learn about the first, that is Newton's forward interpolation formula. Newton's forward interpolation formula, that is here the interval will be, whatever we are considering, they all are with the equal interval. H will be the same here. Let y0, y1, so on up to yn be the set of values of a function y is equal to f of x be a corresponding to the values of x, that is x0, x1 is equal to, please remember, x0 plus h, and x2 is equal to x0 plus 2h. Then xn will be x0 plus nh. Then the value of y is equal to f of x at x is equal to x0 plus rh. R is the difference here, that is y is equal to f of x0 plus rh. Please remember this formula. This is the formula used to calculate Newton's forward interpolation formula. That is y is equal to f of x0 plus rh, which is equal to y0 plus r delta y0 plus r into r minus 1 divided by 2 factorial delta square y0 plus r into r minus 1 into r minus 2 divided by 3 factorial into delta cube y0, so on up to the last term, that is r into r minus 1 into r minus 2, so on up to r minus n minus 1 term divided by n factorial into delta n y0. Therefore, here you know y0 value and delta y0, delta square y0, that is the second difference, this is third difference, and this is the nth difference. What is r? R is nothing but, we have to calculate by using the formula, x minus x0 divided by h. H is the difference between two consecutive value of x. X is, they will be given the value. For particular value, they told you to calculate y. That value will be substituted in place of x, and x0 is the initial value, and h is the common difference between the x. And similarly, the backward difference, the Newton backward interpolation formula is given by, there is a slight change. See here, y is equal to f of x at x is equal to xn plus rh. There we used to take x0 here in the backward, xn, as we have done in the backward difference. Therefore, the formula is y of xn plus rh, which is equal to yn plus r into delta yn plus r into r plus 1 divided by 2 factorial delta square yn, so on up to the nth term. Here, r is calculated by x minus xn divided by h. X naught is replaced by, y naught is replaced by yn, and here, there we used to take x naught, here xn, and in the above formula, that is in the forward difference, we are using the minus, in the backward we are using the plus, only that is the difference, rest all everything is same. Now they will give the problem, and but you have to judge whether we have to apply the forward difference formula or the backward difference formula. How we have to judge means, they will tell you to estimate the value of y at some value of x. If x is lying in the first half of the table, then we are considering the forward, I mean the Newton forward interpolation formula. If x is lying outside, the second half of the table, then we are using backward difference, that is backward interpolation formula. Now look at this example, you will get. Find the value of y at x is equal to 1.4 using the following data. They will be given the table, and here x is equal to what? 1.4. If x, please see the x values, 1.4 is lying first half of the table. Therefore, we are using Newton forward interpolation. If x is equal to 4.5, then we have to take backward interpolation formula. Please remember it. Now, therefore, we are using Newton forward interpolation formula, and write the formula. After writing the formula, your job is to first form the forward difference table. That is, x values will be given, y values will be given. The first difference, second difference, and the third difference, and the fourth difference, you need to calculate it. Already I told how to calculate. That is 26 minus 10 is 16, 56 minus 26 is 32, 112 minus 56 is 54, 194 minus 112 is 82. Similarly, subtracting here, your last value is delta 4. R we have to calculate, x minus x naught divided by h. X is 1.4, x naught is 1, and difference is also 1. See here. 2 minus 1, 3 minus 2, 4 minus 3, 5 minus 4 is equal to 1. If I simplify, 0.4. Now please substitute in the formula up to the third term we have to calculate, because the fourth term is 0. Therefore, till delta q, we have to write the formula. That is till here, from here to here. Substitute the values in the formula, then y of 1.4, after simplifying this, you are going to get 14.864 as the answer. Next example, the area of the circle A corresponding to the diameter D is given below. I mean, instead of x and y, they have given diameter and area. Therefore, the values will be given. They told you to estimate 105. Okay, see here, 105 is lying second half of the table, that is extrapolation. Therefore, we are using backward interpolation formula. First, judge that whether it is forward or backward. After writing that statement, form the forward difference table with respect to backward or forward. After forming the table, substitute in the formula. If we are using the forward difference, write the forward difference formula, then otherwise the backward interpolation formula. After that, from the given table, whatever we have formed from those table, from that table, please substitute the values of y. Here, see here, subtracting this, I'll get from this. If I subtract this from this, then this, see, the procedure is going to continue. Then the last value is 4. Substitute all the values here, and r will be calculated by x minus xn divided by n. N is nothing but 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Here, sorry, that is h, not n. H is 85 minus 80 is 5. Common length here is, this is h is nothing but 5, x is 105, then this will be 1. Therefore, after substituting r, delta yn, delta square yn, and delta cube yn, and delta 4 yn, you are going to get the answer. The area will be 8,666. Please remember the given, based on the given value of x, we have to decide whether we have to apply the forward interpolation or the backward interpolation. After that, form the table and substitute all the values in that formula, then calculate it. You are going to get the answer. Thank you.